Good afternoon.
Welcome to South Church in Andover. Thank you to our South Church ringers. I can't walk and chew gum, and they were walking and ringing. Thank you for that. What a beautiful way to begin this special occasion. I have the honor to welcome you here for this service of installation for the Reverend Genevieve Hosterman as our associate pastor here. Jenna arrived at South Church on August 22nd, and over these past 6 months, she has quickly gained the affection and love of our congregation. It is a gift to make the covenant between Jenna and South Church official today with this service of installation. We welcome today not just South Church members and friends, but clergy, colleagues, Jenna's husband, Zach, and Jenna's family, who is joining us virtually from Pennsylvania. We begin our time together with the words that Jenna and I offer as a welcome to the South Church community every Sunday morning. This is God's house, and in God's house there is room for everyone, of every background and belief, of every race, creed, and culture, of every gender and sexual orientation, of every emotion and ability. We are better and stronger because you are with us this day. After worship, we invite everyone to join us downstairs for a reception in honor of Jenna and this shared covenant. It looks like a beautiful spread. You don't want to miss it. Thank you for the people that helped to organize that reception. Please take a moment and join us downstairs. Friends, let us be fully present here to the ways that the Spirit moves in and among us. Let us be present here for this moment of celebration. Let us pray. God, in a world full of weariness and despair, it is such a gift to gather together and celebrate. May this time of worship be a reminder of how important the bonds of covenant are to sustain us. And may each of us be reminded that we are worthy of the call to love and serve you and your people. Amen.
Thank you.
A reading from the book of Ephesians, chapter 4, verses 1 through 6. I, therefore, the prisoner in the Lord, beg you to walk in a manner worthy of the calling to which you have been called, with all humility and gentleness, with patience, bearing with one another in love, making every effort to maintain the unity of the Spirit in the bond of peace. There is one body and one Spirit. Just as you were called to the one hope of your calling, one Lord, one faith, one baptism, one God and Father of all, who is above all and through all and in all. Holy wisdom, holy words. Thanks be to God.
Good people, would you pray with me? Good and loving God, bless the words of my mouth and the meditations of each of our hearts, that they might be found pleasing and acceptable in your sight, for you are our rock and our redeemer. Amen. So whether you are a fan of the Philadelphia Eagles or the Kansas City Chiefs, I hope you'll join me in putting aside all our differences and coming together to worship God in spirit and in truth. Because when it comes to our faith, there's no need to choose sides. We're all on the same team, and we're all working together to spread the love and hope of Jesus Christ to a world that so desperately needs it. I didn't write that opening paragraph. It was written by an artificial intelligence chatbot. Right now, Jenna is totally regretting having me preach, trust me. She hates this more than anything. In November, when this was developed, I texted her and I was like, can you believe this? Artificial intelligence chatbots can create sermons and prayers and news. She was like, yeah, no, I hate that. I will never use that. I love that. So for those of you who don't know, generative artificial intelligence is everywhere now. These AI chatbots can create text for your next social media post, for your prayer, for an article that you want to write. And I cannot imagine how high school English teachers everywhere are scrambling to rewrite curriculum as these chatbots create a Grapes of Wrath essay in less than a minute. Apparently, one essay written by a chatbot received a solid B from Wharton School of Business. As if a global pandemic and increasing secularization and the decline of institutions weren't already posing a threat to the church, we now have chatbots coming for the role of preachers. Instead of 20 hours on a sermon or 1 hour for every minute preached, it could be done in less than 2 minutes by an artificial intelligence chatbot. Good people, though, can this calling of pastor, teacher, preacher be replaced by artificial intelligence? God, I hope not. In our scripture for today, we hear these poignant words from Paul to the church at Ephesus, where he reminds them that their calling is from God. Jenna isn't the only one here called this day. All of you are called as God's beloved. You are called to a life of service, connection, meaning, and purpose. Jenna's call is particular and unique. She's called as United Church of Christ pastor to serve the church and its people. In Jenna's profile, under the section describing her sense of call, she quoted poet and theologian Frederick Buechner. The place God calls you to is the place where your deep gladness and the world's deep hunger meet. She then went on to say, much of my sense of call is driven by deep gladness. I relish the diversity, strangeness, and creativity of ministry, but it is in combination with the gladness that this desire to meet people in their deep hunger that truly fuels my call. Over these last 6 months, we have got to witness Jenna as an extraordinarily gifted pastor. She's brilliant, deeply caring, hardworking, committed. She's fun to be around and has a great love for the church and its people. Jenna could also teach a master class on how to onboard as a pastor to your new call. She's done it extraordinarily well, intentionally visiting each program, small group, team, committee, and service project. She's connected with individuals to get to know their personal stories. She's gotten to know the history of our church and how we hold our hopes for our future. On a Sunday, it's not unusual to see Jenna proclaim a good word from our pulpit and then go sing with our church choir. What gifts she has. For the church in Ephesus, people were used to familiar binaries and categories. Jews and Greeks, male and female, slave and free. Jesus broke apart all those binaries and invited them to bear with one another in love, to speak the truth, not out of fear, but in love, to seek unity, not uniformity, to remain in relationship, even when things are not easy or convenient. This is why artificial intelligence will never replace the role of pastor and preacher. We are called to the work of embodied leadership rooted in the beautiful messiness of this human experience. We are called to break down binaries and to proclaim the paradox of this Christian faith, one that is rooted in an ancient and sacred text, yet remarkably relevant even today. One that is rich and full of tradition and ritual, yet bravely creative and boldly innovative. One that prophetically proclaims the truth in love, yet pastorally meets each person where they are. This is not easy work. It is not a light lift to walk in a manner worthy of your calling. Recently, I heard the quote from Harvard professor Lisa Leahy, "Everyone wants transformation, but no one wants change." We are a culture that loves a good transformation. Nothing like queer eye transformation of a house routine or wardrobe. The transformation stories of scripture stick with us. Jacob to Israel, Saul to Paul, fishermen who become devoted disciples. Transformation is the shiny result. Change requires diligence, strategy, intentionality. The work of the pastor is to be a change agent. The pastor stands on that hinge between what has been and what will be. The pastor sees resistance as part of the process and remains non-anxious even as fears arise. And like we see in the letter to the church at Ephesus, Paul won't let them settle for the status quo. He won't allow them to dissolve into conflict and division. He reminds them of the faithfulness of God, and he paints a picture of what could be. Paul writes, "Walk in a manner worthy of the calling to which you have been called, with all humility and gentleness, with patience, bearing with one another in love, making every effort to maintain the unity of the Spirit in the bond of peace." Real change is never accidental. And a congregation like South Church has the power to bring transformative change, not just to the people who sit in our pews that never could have imagined a progressive Christian church, but also to the world out there, to the broader Merrimack Valley. Jenna, you are worthy of this call, and God has equipped you with what you need to be a transformative force for good here in our church and in the world. Yet, as everyone sitting in these front pews know, the expectations and demands and needs of pastoral ministry can reduce even the best pastors and leaders to what Stanley Hauerwas calls a quivering mass of availability. And you, my dear Jenna, are an Enneagram 2. You love to be helpful and needed. So in order to stay close to this sacred call that God has placed on your heart, I invite you to befriend disappointment, your own and others, and to mine its lessons for spiritual wisdom. Have confidence in the fact that each thing you turn away, you have the opportunity to get in touch with the greater thing you turn toward. Behind each disappointment, each no is a greater yes, not every time, but over time. Let yourself continue to stay in touch with that deeper yes, and let its bright star guide you. So I want to offer you some things in which I might have you say yes, but I encourage you to think of your own, and for everyone here to think of what you might say yes to. What is that deeper yes that guides you? Yes to the fact that you are held in a love greater than you could ever imagine. Yes, when that love shows up in the form of homemade jam on your desk at the end of a long day of meetings. Yes to the sermon that gets written on Saturday night and is halfway decent on Sunday morning. Yes to the people and practices that keep you grounded in humor and humility. Yes to your love for art and fashion and music. May it always be a window into the world of the Creator. Yes to this glorious calling that asks us to use every part of who we are and invites us to rely on God's strength and grace to bridge the chasms of our imperfections. Yes to the pleasure of finding many and varied companions and colleagues and clergy friends along the way. Yes to the fact that you might feel the scrutiny of the eyes of the community, but they are not looking for your perfection. They are looking to how you find your way back to grace after you falter. Yes to finding rest in the joy and laughter and song that God has given us in abundance. And even in your longest day of having to say no, let yourself be claimed by each and every yes. Amen.
For today's offering, Jenna has chosen that the offering be received as a gift to the scholarship for the Northeast Association Scholarship for the Benefit of Members in Discernment for Authorized Ministry to Aid in Their Journey. Trust me, it can be a long journey. There's a difference between this and wearing this. And for some, it could be almost 10 years. It is a well thought out process that a computer cannot be a minister, that we are called. But with that calling comes time and expense. And your offering today will do wonders for those who are going through that process when unforeseen expenses come into fruition and we do not know where it's going to come from. But your offering will help offset that. And we thank Jenna for choosing this for all those members in discernment. If you want to partake in this offering, let me get this straight, and you would like to give, there are plates in the back on your way out, or you can do so by placing the offering in the back of the sanctuary, or by texting Give to South Church, space UCC, to 73256. Let's join our hearts as we pray for these gifts. Creator God, never let a computer take our positions. Let our words come from our heart and come from our minds and come from your love and your guidance. We thank you for the privilege of being called, and we pray for all those members in discernment that we might seek wisdom and that we might see it in the authority of all those that are already wearing the stole, that we can be the best ministers and have the best ministry to those in the world so that we can spread your glory, your love, your acceptance, and your joy. And we thank you in Christ's name. Amen.
Thank you. God has gathered us in this moment. I'll move to this mic. God has gathered us in this moment as we come to praise God for holy unions of pastor and church, and to give thanks for the bonds of covenant that make of us a united church of Christ. So on behalf of my church, the Ballardvale United Church, and on behalf of the Northeast Association of the Southern New England Conference of the United Church of Christ, I greet you in the name of Jesus Christ, the head of the church in heaven and on earth.
South Church, under the guidance of the Holy Spirit, has called the Reverend Genevieve Hosterman as its pastor and teacher. We respectfully request that the Northeast Association install her in this ministry according to the faith and order of the United Church of Christ.
The Northeast Association has reviewed your request, South Church. We have prayerfully examined Jenna. What can I say? In cooperation and covenant with you, we are pleased to install her as your pastor and teacher. Jenna, servant of God, will you come forward as you accept the call to this office? Installation confirms and celebrates the covenantal relationship among the local church, its pastor, and the United Church of Christ. It's a sign that these covenantal partners are committed to share mutually in the mission of the United Church of Christ and of Christ Church in the world. Scripture tells us to honor all those who labor among us and help us in the Christian life. It also admonishes pastors to be faithful and loving shepherds, which we know you are, merciful and patient with all. So, dear pastor and congregation, pay attention to this holy word. Cultivate mutual love and honor Christ, the head of the church, who is your peace. Installation sounds so mechanical, but we know it's the fruit of prayerful, discerning people gathering together to listen deeply for the movement of the Holy Spirit. In our tradition, that happens first with our search committees. And so I'd ask, if you were on the search committee that searched for Jenna, if you could rise and be recognized. This ministry partnership we are about to seal depends on the fruitfulness of these covenants made and the mutual commitment of all bodies to walk together in all of God's ways. And so I ask you, Jenna, are you willing to affirm this covenant with the members of South Church and with us in the Northeast Association?
I am so near as God shall give me grace. And I promise to serve this church faithfully, preaching and teaching the word of God, administering the sacraments, and fulfilling the pastoral office according to the faith and order of the United Church of Christ.
Members of South Church, I invite you now to rise in body or spirit and affirm your covenant with your pastor and teacher. You receive Jenna. Please remain standing, and members of the Northeast Association, representatives of other faith communities, friends, and family, will you now please rise and affirm your covenant with South Church and its pastor and teacher? We, your family, friends, fellow United Church of Christ members and colleagues, stand with you, the people, ministers, and pastors of South Church, as a sign of our covenant and in celebration of our mutual ministry. Please be seated, but not for too long. Jenna, I'm gonna invite you to come forward here. Is this mic? Okay. Is this on? Okay. I can't tell. We are about to do a laying on of hands, an ancient Christian rite that goes way back to the beginning. And so I invite first the search committee to come forward to lay their hands upon Jenna. And then after the search committee comes forward, and Dana, come forward too, we'll have people who are called to come forward, all of us here. You can lay your hand on Jenna, or if you can't, just lay your hand on somebody whose hand is touching the somebody whose hand. So let us all come forward now in this ancient rite. What a witness we have here today for you, Jenna. And all the virtual hands that are reaching out to us from all across the country, from Pennsylvania and beyond, are here with us. And so we ask, pour out your spirit, God. Pour out your spirit on your servant, Jenna. Pour out your spirit on this church and on who we join in covenant today. Bless us with that spirit that we can do the things you have called us to do, the things we can only do relying on your grace. Bless us beyond our imagining that we may be fruitful in every good work and change the world. Bless us so that your good news may be seen and heard and embraced because we have told it and lived it and shared it. Make of us one church united to give hope in a despairing world. Peace in the torn apart places, unbounded joy where there is deep sadness and love to the loveless. Evoke a big yes from Jenna, from the people of South Church, and from all the churches and people of this association and community so that your love and justice are made real in our midst and irresistible to the world. In Christ who unites us, we pray. Amen.
Amen.
In the name of Jesus and on behalf of the Northeast Association of the Southern New England Conference of the United Church of Christ, I declare you to be duly installed as associate pastor and teacher of South Church. Thanks be to God. We can return to our seats. I believe there's going to be some gifts.
I know. So, Jenna, I'm going to hand this to you just so you could hold it for a second.
Oh, my gosh.
So, this is a coffee station for her office. This was put together by the South Church staff because Jenna's office is beautiful and cozy and way too fashionable, but there's also, she loves her coffee and biscotti, so we added to that and created a little bit of a coffee space for you that you can put together in your office.
Oh my gosh, this is, there are 5 boxes of biscotti in the
bathroom. Yes. We fully expect her to share.
Yeah,
I mean,
so
it goes
well.
Both ways, so yes, yes.
Oh my gosh, it's
so
beautiful.
So Jenna, I'm gonna put it down, yeah.
Or,
yeah. So in this bag are gift cards to your favorite places, Cafe Nero, Andover Deli, and also a check for you to be able to buy robe, stole, collar, whatever you would feel you need for this work. So yeah, thanks to the generosity of the South Church community for that. And this you should open. This is the beautiful work of our quilting group.
Oh. Mm-hmm. I'm trying to find them. Oh my goodness. Oh my gosh. Mm-hmm. Beautiful. Thank you. Oh my goodness. Wow. Thank you.
Excellent. It's awful to go after the presents. I will just say that. I will also say, Dana, we should have compared notes. All is fine. All is fine. Friends, South Church, my name is David Clark, and I am a minister at Hancock Church in Lexington, where I first met your wonderful new associate minister, Jenna. And she has asked me here today to stand before you on this fantastic occasion to deliver a charge. And I have one more note. If you were to look into your bulletin, it says, "Charge to the Pastor." Well, that's something that you do at an ordination, at an installation. It tends to be a charge to the church, a charge to the congregation. And I don't think, though, that I could do that. With my history with Jenna, I don't think that I could do that without including her in that. So stick with me for a little bit here. There's a lot about Jenna that I know, that I know you know already, but if you do not know it yet, please take it from a third party, someone outside of it. And Jenna, this is what you get for asking me to do this. You have a fantastic associate minister in the Reverend Hosterman. I feel very fortunate to count her among my closest friends in both ministry and in life. She is someone of deep emotional understanding, tremendous instinct to embody Christ's love to all people, and possesses a truly thrilling and exciting theological intellect that should make you sweat. If you have a Bible question, or if you'd like to refute a Bible statement from Jenna, do your homework. She should make you sweat a little, and she should also make you dream wildly, wildly about all the things that you can do in the name of your faith here and around the world. And so with all of that, I am to charge you, South Church, you and your wonderful minister, in time, here, at the beginning, though it is not the beginning, because you have been together now for 6 months, this season of beginning that you are now in. And so, the first charge that I have is just to you people. So, Dana and Jenna, if you like, you can la-la-la for a little bit. That's fine. I won't judge you if you do. Because South Church, whether you are here or you are worshiping online, I come to bring you good news of great joy, and it is that you have called her. You have installed her. You have a loving pastor now. You have a great leader right now. You have a careful and a competent and a faithful minister now. So please do not make excuses and enjoy it now. enjoy the hard and beautiful work that you are doing together, the worship that you are celebrating, the traditions that you are continuing, and the new blooms that you are bringing into life right now. And I am saying to do these things now, as opposed to believing or suggesting that you need to wait, that you need to wait for some hypothetical future. That building something meaningful together or loving each other or stepping into whatever next big thing you got brewing has to wait until one day. That one day you will have a loving pastor in her. That one day you will have a great leader in her. Or that one day she will be careful enough or competent enough or faithful enough to minister to you. Because South Church, today is that day. You have her. She is here now. Do not think you must wait. The flower is bloomed. That was good. And I know that you have been with her for 6 months now already. I do know this. So this isn't really the moment, but I feel that the charge still stands. Do not put your dreams, your goals, your ideas, do not put yourselves on the shelf and push to the back for one day. It is now. So make something wonderful of it, because with Jenna involved, you can do anything. Now, for you both, Jenna and the church, something maybe a little bit deeper in, but it's what has been rattling around in my mind since Jenna asked me to do this. What does this need? And it is this thing, to remind you of the fact that the two of you together, South Church and Jenna, you are not going to be able to solve each other's problems. You are not going to do that. You did not call her for that. And Jenna, you did not say yes to that. South Church, you called a minister, not medication. And Jenna, and you know this, because you told me this, that we plant gardens. We don't keep ledgers. Because, siblings in Christ, our times are frightening. I do not need to tell you much. You feel it. You know it. We all know it. With fascism and hunger and homelessness, churches across the board, especially the progressive voices in decline, watching politicians legislate with eager bigotry against the most vulnerable. When these things come to your door, they have already, I bet, and they will come again. When they do, and they test you, they test your constitution, your faith, and the bonds of this, your church, I charge you both to remember. Remind yourselves that you chose each other to be partners in finding the way, not solving each other's problems. You are not each other's magic wand. South Church, she is not your fairy god pastor. And Jenna, they are not your magical mystery church. You chose each other instead to be the one that late at night, after you have put the kids to bed, you sit down together at the kitchen table with, lay it all out, hash it out, and either find or create a way forward together. Not to languish or blame or scheme, but face the realities defiantly and head on together. And what a gift it is for each of you to have such a partner in each other. Lastly, here, in the beginning of your season of your ministry together, South Church and Jenna united, with all that you do, all the work of you, the church, all the organizations that you support, the programs that you run, the money that you raise, before all of it, I charge you, South Church and Pastor Hosterman, before all of it, I charge you to worship first. Worship first and fully and deeply. Enter into it with open hearts and full minds, looking for the Spirit. Leave the work, the roles, the titles, the agendas just outside, and celebrate the body of Christ and the inbreaking of God with absolutely everything that you've got. Do it in the car, on the way to work, or on your way to the next meeting. Do it silently. Do it at home in your pajamas. Most certainly, do it here in this house that you keep for God together. I charge you to worship first, because that is the well that you draw from together when you go to do anything else. I have worshiped with Jenna for years now, and I have to tell you how happy I am that she is here with you all, and how sad I am that we don't get to do this together anymore. But it's okay, because I believe in what you will create together. It fills me with excitement and joy, so do it. Worship well and deeply and loudly and softly and traditionally, and do it as weirdly as you please sometimes. Don't let anything stand in your way, but always be sure to do it first, and always be sure to do it together. Friends, this is hard work. It is beautiful work, and thank God that it is ours to do, because if the kingdom of God is to come in our lives, let us be the ones to bring it in. Let it start here. Amen. Friends, amen.
Shouldn't have picked a sermon that kills me every time before the benediction. Beloved South Church, receive these words of blessing as we go out to continue what we have been doing, which is to worship, to work, and to love together in community. And what a joy it has been. Receive these words of blessing. May you know that neither height, nor depth, nor angels, nor demons, nor powers, nor principalities can separate you from the love of God. And may you know that love incarnate in this beloved community as we bear with one another in love. And may you know it in each breath, which is the holiest of gifts. Go in peace to love and serve now and always. Amen.